To link GenAI to business objectives, there are two exercises all of you need to be doing. One is truly understanding what GenAI can do, understanding what are the tools, the methodologies, the software packages out there that exist, and what are they good for, what they can be used for versus not. At the same time, you need to do the constant business hygiene of thinking through what are your customers' biggest pain points, what are they really solving for, and what is going to give you competitive advantage. And you're doing those two things in parallel, and just the discipline of going through the thinking motion of how can you use GenAI to solve these biggest problems is something that needs to be a regular rhythm and part of your ongoing muscle build. And if you do that in a consistent way, you're going to start identifying those opportunities of how you're embedding GenAI into everything you're doing. So you really need to focus on the outcomes at scale so that you can identify which parts of the end-to-end process will really make a difference if you optimize them. If you optimize some that are not a bottleneck at all, you could make them 50% efficient, but it doesn't change the overall outcome either for your customers or for the quality of the products that you're putting out there. So you really need to think end to end and focus on things that will make a difference. The number one thing the companies are getting wrong with how they're deploying GenAI is either waiting and not doing anything or completely outsourcing the thinking to third parties or the software vendors to figure it out for them. You really need to own this. You need to embed it into everything you do, and it's not a project, it's a part of an ongoing program, and it should become part of your DNA.